Okay, this is worksheet number 2. Question number 1 was add these two expressions. Ashita, see, you have to see which are the like terms that you can add directly. Okay, so this root 7 is an irrational number, root 2 is an irrational number, root 11 is an irrational number. In this side also we have root 7, root 2 and root 11. So what we have done first is we have opened the brackets considering the signs. So when you open this bracket, you will get simply these three. Sorry, I have just written them in like format, that 2 by 3 root 7 from here, 1 by 3 root 7 from here, that is only was in positive only. Then we have minus 1 by 2 root 2, and this was 3 by 2 root 2, 6 root 11 and minus root 11. So what I have done is I have written all the like terms together. After that you can do it directly also, but I have taken by taking common. So root 7 was common, inside was 2 by 3 plus 1 by 3. Similarly here root 2 is common. If you see, I have taken common plus root 2. Ashita, please see this thing. I have taken common plus root 2. That's why inside we have got minus 1 by 2 and plus 3 by 2. If I had taken minus root 2 common, what will we write inside? Please tell class. If we take common minus root 2, what will we write inside? As negative is taken common, everything inside will be changed. Please confirm. What will come? Yes, Anuranjan. So inside we will get 1 upon 2 minus 3 by 2. The reason being, if you open it again, you will get the same thing back. So whenever you take negative common, inside signs will change. That is why I went for taking plus root 2 common, so that I don't have to change anything inside. And that's why I got minus 1 by 2 and 3 by 2. This is other case. If you go for this, you have to go like that. Then I took common this root 11 and got 6 minus 1. Okay. And finally, this is the term that we have got. This 3 by 3. By solving this, we got 2 by 2. From this, we got 5. And then solving, we got the final answer as root 7 plus root 2 plus 5 root 11. Ashita, please confirm. Anything else you want to ask in this? Okay, it is clear now. Next one. Question number 2. Anyone wants to ask? Question number 2. In this, we had to multiply 3 root 28 by 2 root 7. Again, we will try to first simplify the under root and see if it is possible to solve it or not. When I tried that, we got 3 root 28 can be written as 3 root 7 into 2 into 2. By prime factorization, we have done this, because 2, then there is 14, 2 7s are and 7 1s are. So writing like this helps us to take this 2 outside. We have got 6 root 7 and 2 root 7. Now one more thing, whether you write like this, 3 root 28, or you write like this, they both are same thing. They both mean the same thing. Just consider this 3 is outside the root. If it was like this, then it was a different case. Then it is a cube root. Then it is a cube root or power 1 by 3. But in this case, they are getting multiplied. That's why, to show you this thing, I have written like this, 3 into 2 multiplied with root 7, then 2 multiplied with root 7. And finally, we got 3 to the 6, 6 to the 12, and root 7 to root 7 become 7. And the answer is 84. I hope it was easy for everyone. Question number 3, anyone having doubt? In question number 3, anyone having doubt? Please ask. Just confirm by P or R, because it is similar question. In this also we simplified the under root and then we simplified it easily. It was very easy to solve, just involving the rules of exploration towers. Okay, good. So let's see the next one. Simplify question number. Okay, first question number 4. This one. In this one, please see we had to simplify root 5 minus root 2 multiplied with root 2 minus root 3. To solve such kind of questions, let's take an idea from this thing. Distribution property we have done. To open a bracket, what we do is we multiply A with B as well as with C and write like this. AB plus AC. Similar to this, if the question becomes like this, A plus B bracket C plus D, in this time we will distribute this over them. How? So doubt in question number 5, Abin. Okay, Abin, we will discuss that. So we open it like this, A bracket C plus D plus B bracket C plus D. Same thing I have followed over here. For me, this is A. First, I have multiplied root 5 in the complete second bracket, then minus sign. Then I have multiplied this root 2 in this complete second bracket. And then I solved it to get the answer as this. Please confirm in this if you have any doubt in this opening of brackets. Just confirm by P or R this thing, opening of bracket. Distribution property we have used in this one. So first we multiplied the second bracket with root 5 and then with root 2. And we solved it to get the answer. Question number 5, in which Avin has doubt. Let's see. Let me take red pen. So it is easy. Avin, let's see. We have 2 root 30 upon root 6 minus 3 root 140 upon root 28 plus root 50 upon root 99. So as I have said, we always try to first simplify the roots or the given expression before proceeding further. If you see, this root 6 is not, this 6 is not a prime number, so we can write it in the terms of its multiples, that is 2 into 3. Then similarly, root 30, we have done prime factorization and we have got 2 3 are 6, 6 5 are 30. Similar way we have done here also. 140 can be written as 14 into 10. 14 can be written as 2 into 7, and this can be written as 2 into 5. That's why I have written like this. And similarly for this also, I have done. Then 55 can be written as 5 into 11, 99 like this. After this, I have just opened all the roots and written like this, 2 into root 2 into root 3 into root 5. They are the same thing. Abin, I hope you are able to understand this thing, that root 2 into 3 into 5 is same as root 2 into root 3 into root 5. Abin, please confirm. Can we write like this? Because if you solve this, you will get the same thing back. Why? Because 2 power 1 by 2 into 3 power 1 by 2 into 5 power 1 by 2 can be written as 2 into 3 into 5 power 1 by 2 using the same formula that we have done. If bases are different and power is same, we can multiply the bases and keep the power same. Abin, are you able to understand this thing? Please confirm. Okay. But Abin, if this was the case, 2 plus 3 plus 5, can we do this thing? Class, please confirm. If this was the case that we had under root 2 plus 3 plus 5, can we distribute like this? Under root 2 plus under root 3 plus under root 5? This is not possible, okay, because this is not using any law of exponent and power. So this is not possible. This we have to take care of while solving the question, that if plus sign is there, we cannot take them out like this. So the reason behind taking out was I could have cut it like this only to show you the solution, but I wanted you to understand why we are able to cut this in this way. So root 2 into root 3, I have written like this. Sir, we need to add it first. Yes, beta. in this thing, we need to add it first. It becomes 2 plus 3, 5 plus 5, 10. So it is actually root 10. Okay, good Garima. So this is the case. So root 2 and root 2 cancel, root 3 and root 3 cancel. We are left with 2 and root 5 only in the first expression. In the second one, if you see, minus 3, again I have opened the root and we got 2 outside. Root 7 was left, root 5 was left, root 7 got cancelled. And similarly in this one also. And we got this answer eventually as minus 2 root 5 upon 3. Whatever was left, we just solved that. Sir, can a power m plus b power m is equal to a plus b whole power m? No, actually, Ayush, let's see your example. Plus, Ayush is saying, sir, can we say a power m plus b power m is equal to a plus b whole power m? It is not possible. Just for 2 only, you can see. If I take m equal to 2, just consider for this one, a square plus b square, can you write like this? Ayush. And if you want to see by an example also, you can see, suppose you have 2 square plus 2 square is equal to, is it correct? Is this a relation holding that you are saying? It will not hold. That's why we have got that identity, a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. Okay. There is a whole lot of, so we cannot say like this. Okay. This is not possible because this is 4 plus 4 is equal to 8. This is actually 4 square, that is 16. So there is a difference. Okay. You cannot say they are same. Now, only in the case of 0, when a and b are 0, then this relation will hold. Else it will not. Okay. Now, question number 4 is done. Question number 6 now. Represent root 5 on number line. This concept we have done. On this concept we have done many questions. But the same way we will follow here also. You have to take this root 5 or whatever they are asking from you as the hypotenuse. So you can see I have drawn a triangle. Because this question is based on, or this question can be done with the help of PGT only. So that is why I have taken this as root 5 and called it ABC. This is the right angle. This is the base. This is the perpendicular. So you can see here also, I have applied the PGT theorem. By that, I got root 5 square is equal to B square plus P square, or 5 is equal to B square plus P square. Then just to show you that what are the possibilities, I have written that the value of B can be 1 and P can be 4. Sorry, not B, B square. So we are writing the possible values of B square and P square. That can be 1 and 4, 4 and 1, 2 and 3, 3 and 2. Plus, what was the issue with this case? If we want to draw root 5 from these two, that is also possible. The issue is only one, that in this case, we have to do a lot of work to find the answer. Because if you take b square as 2, what will be the value of b? Please tell. If we take b square as 2, what will be the value of b? It will be plus minus root 2. Why plus minus? I have told you, whenever there is a power of 2, that means you will have two solutions. One solution in the plus 1 and one in the minus 1. It is our choice that we are going for the plus 1, but we will always get two solutions from a quadratic equation. Okay, from linear we get one equation, from quadratic we get two solutions. Similarly, the value of p square, if you take as 3, then p will become plus minus root 3. So now your job will be to first make a base of root 2. That will take some time, because for root 2 you get one base, one height, then you get root 2. That will give you the base root 2. After that you will make a root 3 over it. So quite cumbersome process it will be. That is why we went for the first value. In this, there was no issues at all. Why? As soon as you took b square equal to 1, it was very simple for you to get the value of b as plus minus 1 And if you take p square as 4, you will get p equal to plus minus 2. That is why I went for this one. And this is the reason why we should write all the possible values of b square and p square. Maybe we get a easier combination that will work for us. Now you can see what we have done is, whatever I have done, I just wrote those steps for the SOC. Now, first step is same. Make a number line, mark the points. After marking, what we have to do is we have to first consider the base. In our case, we have taken base as 1 unit and P as 2 unit. This triangle only we have to make, the same triangle ABC, nothing else. So the first thing is, I will call this 0 as A, I will call this 1 as B. So I have taken AB as 1 unit. Then after that, I have drawn a perpendicular on B because I want to draw a perpendicular. So this is the thing. After drawing the perpendicular, we want 2 units on this perpendicular. For that, I have taken a compass on this B and cut this arc at C. So we have got this also. Now, obviously, if this is 1 unit, this is 2 unit, joining A and C, this AC will be how much? Plus, obviously, we have proved this thing above also, that if a base is of 1 unit and the height is of 2 unit, then the AC or the hypotenuse will be of root 5 units. But we want this root 5 on the number line, not in the air. To get that on number line, we will take this A as center, this AC as radius, and we'll try to draw a circle. So we will get the point over here. Because root 5 is obviously more than 2. Plus, while you are getting the point on the number line, you can also think in your mind that root 5 is obviously more than root 4. That will give you a clear picture. Root 5 is obviously more than root 4 and less than root 9, that is 2 and 3. So this gives me the hint that my value should come between 2 and 3. And if it is not coming, that means something is wrong in my calculation or the values that I have taken are wrong. So I hope this point is clear to everyone. Today again, I have given you a question in which you have to actually use root. Okay. So this was the thing, and you can also show like this. Writing these will make it clear for the invigilator that what you are doing is mentioned on this right side. Also, these steps are not that tough to write. Whatever you are doing, just you have to need to write that. That's enough. If the question is of 3 or 4 marks, it is better to write the steps. If it is of 2 marks, then it's not required. Okay. Question number 7, represent root 10.5 on number line. So this is any real number, right? This was numbers like this. When inside we have a 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, this kind of way we are going. But this is general way. This is the general question. Any value can come, whether it is normal number like integer 5, 4, 3, 2, or some real number or rational number like 2.5, 3.5, anything can come. What we have done in this one is, first, this 10.5 we have drawn as this one. A, B is 10.5 units. Actually, it is 10.5 centimeters if you use your normal scale. Okay, it will be 10.5 centimeters. After that, you have to do one more thing. You have to extend one more unit. Sorry, not this much. You have to extend one more unit. So total become how much? Total becomes 11.5 units. Now the total is 11.5 units. You want to find the midpoint of this 11.5 units. To find the midpoint, many people use scale also, but scale will not give you the correct value because the midpoint of 11.5 will come around 2 fives are 10, then 1 will come 15, 2 sevens are 5. 5.75. So finding the value of 5.75 on the scale is difficult. Why difficult? Because the least count of your scale that you are using is how much? Plus, why it is difficult to get 5.75 in your scale that you normally use? Because of the least count is how much? It is 1 mm. It is not 5 mm. It is 1 mm. Okay. If you see that 1 centimeter is divided in 10 parts, so you can only go for 1 mm minimum. Okay. Not less than that. So to get this midpoint, better way is to go for plus. To find midpoint of any line segment, the best way is to go for perpendicular bisector. For that, I did one mistake. By mistake, I made this diagram on the lower side of the paper. That's why you can see I have this upper arcs, but I'm not having the lower arcs. I thought people will understand. That's why I didn't make it again. But actually, you have to make it in such a place so that you can have the arc above as well as below. So like this, keeping on A, opening it more than half, you will take the first arc over here, second arc here. Similar way, you will keep on C point, that is the last point, and take the arc like this. And by joining or just by keeping the scale, you will get the point O, which is the center of this line segment AC. Now, keeping on O, opening till this AO as radius, you will draw this semicircle. Now, the only thing left is you have to draw a perpendicular on this point B. This will be your root 10.5 and this will be your answer. So this is the only way for the, such kind of questions where you have the values like under root 10.5, under root 7.5, you can go this way. Now, question number 8, anyone having doubt, please ask question number 8. Question number 8, please confirm P or R. If anyone has doubt, type R. What is the small semicircle? Okay, that is not small semicircle. This I used to draw the perpendicular. Okay, you have doubts in question number 8. Fine. Utkarsh, we can, but not right now. Okay, it is not in the scope of this topic for class 9, but we can do. Class, this small, or Vaishnav, this small semicircle was just to draw the perpendicular on point B, nothing else. Now, question number 8. We had to find the value of A and B. This is the equation given to you. The problem is, right now we can't compare. So, let's make this left-hand side, or let's try to simplify this and see, maybe after that we can compare it. For that, we have learned that we should not leave a irrational number in the denominator. Class, if you remember the last exercise of your book, we have learned that we should not leave an irrational number in the denominator. So we must rationalize it. If we have a single number like 1 upon root 3, if you want to make it rationalized, you multiply the numerator by root 3, the denominator by root 3, it becomes root 3 upon 3. It was very simple. But if you have root 3 minus root 2, if you have root 3 minus root 2 and you want to make it a rational number, you have to multiply the numerator and the denominator by root 3 plus root 2. The reason being, you wanted this combination, A minus B into A plus B. That is why I have multiplied with root 3 plus root 2 in the numerator as well as denominator. Bhavya and Ashita, is it clear to you? Please confirm. Why I have multiplied with root 3 plus root 2 only and not root 3 minus root 2? Please confirm. Bhavya and Ashita, why it is not feasible to multiply with root 3 minus root 2? Because it becomes a whole square only and that will not solve the purpose. Still, you will have the root in the denominator. That's why we did this. After that, we just simplified this. This was your whole square like this. And this is your A square minus B square formula. Yes. After solving, we got this thing. Very good, Ishan. After solving, we got this thing. And we got actually 5 plus 2 root 6. Now, if you see, the question was saying that this complete thing equal to A plus B root 6. That is equal to A plus B root 6. When you compare that root 6 and root 6 are there, that means obviously this B must be 2 only. And this A is alone, this is your 5. By comparison, we got the answer as A equal to 5 and B equal to 2. Okay, Bhavya and Ashita, please confirm. Okay. Now, question number 9. If x is equal to 5 minus root 21 upon 2, find the value of x plus 1 by x. Again, directly doing it or just putting the values as it is in this expression and solving will be a little bit difficult. That is why I went for solving 1 by x separately. So, from x, I can say 1 by x is equal to 1 upon 5 minus root 21 upon 2. We have learned if you have this fraction form, what will happen? This D will come on the top and this C will come on the bottom. This we have learned. If you have double fractions in division, this happens. Why this happens? Because in class 7th you have done, if you have A by B divided by C by D, it actually becomes A by B multiply D by C. Class, do you remember this thing? Either you go this way or this way, you will get the same result. Okay. So what we have done is this 2, which was in the lowest strata, it will come on the top like this. So we will have 2 upon 5 minus root 21. Now the same game will go on. That root 21 is an irrational number coming in the denominator. We will try to rationalize it by simply multiplying with, okay, Taranji, don't worry. We multiply it with 5 root 21. And then solving, we got this answer of 1 by x as this much. Now, we just needed to solve this expression. X, we already know. 1 by x, we have found. After solving, we got the answer as 5. That's it. You can always use this solution and try to solve on your own and you will get the answer. Okay. The last question, question number 10. Let's discuss. It is 8:36. It will take only 2 minutes. A is equal to 3 minus 2 root 2. Now we had to find A square minus 1 by A square. Now directly doing square and then solving was not a good idea at all. So the thing came to my mind that this thing must have come from, the idea that came to my mind is that this thing must have come from A plus 1 by A multiplied with A minus 1 by A. Class, is this correct to say so? Can we say A square minus 1 by A square must have come from A plus 1 by A dot A minus 1 by A? Can we say this thing, class? Please confirm. So this makes the question easy, because dealing in the squares was a little difficult and cumbersome. So I went for this. Now we have already the value of A. Only thing we want is value of 1 upon A. And that is a similar process as the above question. 1 by A means you have 1 by 3 minus 2 root 2. Then I multiplied with this thing to rationalize the denominator. After that, we got the value of 1 by A as 3 plus 2 root 2. And just I put these values in the bracket and solving, we got the answer as minus 24 root 2. Still, if there is any doubt while solving the question, you can always ask me on WhatsApp that, sir, my solution is coming this much. I will let you know. Sir, I was getting 0, Vaishnav. Vaishnav, now are you understanding where was the issue? Now you got why you got the wrong answer? Please confirm. Let me stop the recording.